In this review, I'm going to be taking a look at a game that I greatly enjoyed as a child. This game is Animal Crossing. Originally a Nintendo 64 game, released in Japan in 2001 under the name of Animal Forest, this game was later ported over to the United States in 2002 under the name Animal Crossing. The game released a decent sale, selling 2.3 million units overall, and has been featured in Super Smash Bros. Brawl. But now for the question, was this game any good? Well, let's take a look and find out. This game starts you off as any character you choose, male or female, as you head off to live on your own. As you arrive in the city, which you name yourself, you are then greeted by the local shopkeeper raccoon named Tom Nook. Upon buying a house from him, you realize that you don't have enough money. At first, he just has you do errands to pay off your debt, but after a while, he just lets you pay him back at your own convenience. Of course, when you start off, your house is fairly small, so after paying off your house initially, Nook will offer to expand your house. He will make your house larger twice and add a basement and an upstairs area. But don't think these expansions are free. For every expansion, you will have to pay off Nook. But how do you make money to do this? Well, along with just selling you your house, Nook also runs the local shop in town, where you can sell him items such as furniture, fish, bugs, carpets, wallpaper, and clothing. Or you could just cheat. After you finally manage to pay off your house in its entirety, you will get a golden statue in the town square signifying your success. Since you really don't have any time limit as to when you need to pay off your debt, you can just do pretty much whatever you want in the meantime. Along with you and Nook, the town is filled with other animal residents. There are around 200 different possible residents that could populate your town, and residents come and go in real time. By talking to these animals, you can obtain errands from them, or just talk to them and have conversation. By chatting with residents, you'll eventually become friends with them, and they may give you gifts either in person or via mail. But along with just talking, there are many other activities you can participate in. You could go fishing, dig for artifacts, which can be donated to the local museum, catch bugs, or even make your own clothing pattern, which can be used on your shirts or umbrellas. This game is set up fairly sandbox style. It allows you to change the time, day, month, or even year at any given time. Changing the seasons allows you to not only change the overall look of your town, but there are also many holidays in which you can participate. These are holidays such as Halloween, 4th of July, Mother's Day, and Christmas. On each holiday, the town looks slightly different, and you have the opportunity to gain some sort of gift, be it some festive furniture, some new shirts, or wallpaper. Speaking of furniture, this game allows for a large amount of customization when it comes to your house. You can buy all sorts of furniture from Nook, which changes daily due to his change in stock, obtain furniture as gifts from other animals, or you could find some in the local dump. When the furniture is in your inventory, it is in the form of a leaf. Before you ask, I have no idea. When you drop the leaf in your house, it takes the form of the furniture item. Once placed, you can rotate it or move it around as you please. You could just place any item in your house anywhere that you choose, you could try to have some sort of pattern, or you could try the feng shui system, which allows you to place certain colored items in different areas of your house to affect your luck in finding money, which are called bells in the game. Once again, I have no idea. Or affect your luck in finding rare items. Some items you find, such as memorabilia from other Nintendo games, gives you luck no matter what. And now the reviewing. The graphics in this game are okay. They're not particularly good, but considering this was a Nintendo 64 game ported over to the GameCube, it could have been worse. As for the overall gameplay, the movements are very smooth, and interacting with other characters or objects is also fairly easy. The only problem I can find with the gameplay itself is the inventory system. Now, it isn't particularly hard to use the inventory itself, however, moving your cursor around the inventory just feels very slow, thus giving it a rather clunky feeling. So, in conclusion, is this game any good? Well, this is a fairly solid title, and it is rather fun, sort of in the sense that The Sims is fun, but really, I'm not entirely sure what the appeal of this game is. I had this game when it came out, and even recently when I bought it again, I still found myself hooked, but honestly, I'm not sure why it's so fun. So, my piece of advice, if you like games similar to The Sims, then I would probably give this game a try. If you prefer games with more of a story or even an overall goal, then I really wouldn't bother. This game can be found either online or on the Wii Network for around $15. So until next time, this has been E-Dog saying, sometimes I have something witty to say at the end of my videos. today. I do not. See you next time.